Green King Films. We're here with Fletcher Senators head coach Bobby Rawlinson. Hey coach, y'all here with your guys, second week, real quick coach, just talk about that and also let me know what you like about your guys.
The energy and the effort, the enthusiasm has been tremendous. Even today on the second week when you would think they would come back and drag in a little, which they were a little bit, it was still fantastic. And I can't thank our coaching staff enough for being organized and making sure that we're distanced out and practicing what the county has asked us to do. And it's been, I think we're making the most of the situation that nobody expected to find themselves in here in mid-June, but it's been great getting the kids back, getting to see and lay eyes on them every day and be around them again. First day was a little challenging just because you didn't know how many you were gonna have. We had to make sure we had physicals turned in and that everybody that was out here was eligible to be here. But I think, again, I commend our coaching staff for making sure that we've got two coaches at every station. They're keeping everybody distanced. They're making sure that the masks are being worn at all times. And just like anything else, you've got to commit to following the rules and the guidelines here. And I think our staff's done a tremendous job of that.
Yes, sir. Coach, talk about how hard you pushed them last week as well as today and how you like the way they responded.
Well, it's kind of easing them into the deep end of the pool. I think the first couple of days, we pushed them, but it wasn't to the point of really taxing them. And then Wednesday and Thursday, we picked up the pace a little bit. And then today, even, we ratcheted it up another notch today. So I think you've got to be smart with that, because a lot of these young men, as much as you would have liked them to have exercised for the last 3 months, it's not the same as being with you, and everybody knows that. If they're doing it on their own, they're probably not doing it as hard as they would if they were with us. So we're being smart with that and making sure that we watch them. They're bringing their own water bottles, but we also have a cooler in the event nobody brought any. So we're paying attention to all those things, and that's one of the great things about being out here in the mornings, too, is you're not necessarily worried about the 90-degree heat and the humidity, because it's been a great – every morning we've been out, the weather has been fantastic, so that's helped as well.
Yes, sir. Coach, let's talk about some of your talent out here. We all know about Miles Montgomery, yeah. But can you give us something on Miles and what makes him so special, and also talk about some more of your weapons?
Miles is a special talent. You know, you don't rush for 2,000 yards in 10 games and not be special. His vision, his ability to make people miss and at the same time run with power and through people is what makes him special. We've got a tremendous offensive line up front with Chandler Curtin, Mike Bartolucci, Bryce Verrata. Those guys are coming back, and Miles would be the first to tell you that without them, he would not have been able to accomplish what he did last year. And so we're excited about at least the core of that run game coming back, and we know that's going to be our bread and butter, and we're not going to shy away from that. Now, we need to be able to throw the ball with some efficiency off of play action, and quite frankly, we need to find a quarterback and we need to find a group of receivers that can execute those things. But we've got talented kids here that can do those things, and we just got to find them. On the defensive side of the football, we've got some guys that can really play and had great years last year. Jeff Davis at corner, Merritt Reynolds at safety, Josh Davis at outside linebacker, and then of course there's Aaron Hester at defensive end. We've got to find some inside guys at linebacker and then maybe an outside linebacker, but again, we've got candidates there that can fill those spots. They just haven't played a lot of football yet. So that's what's great about this, is you get to lay eyes on them, and it's not the pressure cook situation of having to play a game this Friday. We're kind of watching them run around and beginning to develop the opinions about who can do what. But we've got some talented guys. And we also, I left out the name Tariq Riley at cornerback. We've got him too. So we've got a good core on defense. We just have to find some spots at the linebacker position.
Yes, sir. Coach, for a minute, let's go back to the offensive line. Chandler and Mike, two 6-foot-2 guys, 280-plus. Coach, yeah. Real quick, can you just talk about your hauls on that offensive line and what makes those two guys so special?
The heart and soul of the football team in many ways. And I think most people would tell you that as they go and their energy level goes, the whole team goes. And both of them are tremendous young men off the field. Nearly 4.0 students, great in the community, and you know, they have done things the right way. They emulate what we would want a Fletcher student athlete, in this case a football player, to be, and tough, hard-nosed players. Both of them are going to play at the next level, and that'll all sort itself out here over the next 6 to 8 months. But just tremendous young men who will make sure that we do not fail. And that's the best way that I can describe them.
Yes, sir. Coach, do you think Miles can rush for another 2K behind Chandler and Mikey?
I think he's capable of that, but I don't think we want him to, just because we would like to be able to share the load a little bit. And that's not any disrespect to Miles, because we know he can do it. But it's for us to be a little more balanced and take some of the pressure off of him and not have to give it to him, you know, 30-plus times a game. We've got another young man in Jabari Williams that we feel really good about, who just did not get as many touches last year as we probably should have given him. But he's another guy that can really play, and we're going to find ways to get him the ball to take some of that load off of Miles.
Yes, sir. Coach, let's back up for a minute. You got the job in January. Just real quick, talk about that and how proud you was when they gave you the call, Coach.
Very, very proud. There's nothing like returning returning to your alma mater. As you know, I was at Bishop Kenny for 5 years, and what a tremendous place that was. And the only real public school job I would have left for, it was Fletcher. And when the opportunity presented itself to be able to come teach in the building, not really sure Coach Brown was going to retire, but the opportunity came last year at the last minute to get a job in the building. I was thrilled about that. And then, as fate would have it, Coach Brown retired in December, and I interviewed for the position, and they offered it to me. And as I said, there's not a lot of public school jobs I would even consider leaving Bishop Kenny for, but this was one that is special to me in my heart. I graduated here, and so it means a lot to me and my family. And our coaching staff, we have a lot of guys that are connected to Fletcher, and that's the great thing about being here is the community feel to that.
Yes, sir. Coach, speaking of the community, you've been in this community for a while. Can you just talk about that real quick and the support they showed you when you got the job, Coach?
Yeah, it's been great. Anytime I go out and have dinner with my wife at the beach and have a Fletcher shirt on, somebody's always coming by, and they may not even know that I'm the head coach, but it's just go Senators, and we can't wait till football starts back up again. And that's what makes this position so great, is that it matters to people, and the added stress of being a head coach and the demands of winning are all worth that, because it matters to the community, it matters to the folks in the administration and the school, and why would you want to work anywhere else where it doesn't matter? So that to me is one of the great things about this, is there is still a true community feel to this, and that shows up every Friday night.
Yes, sir. Coach, can you talk about your coaching staff for a bit and what makes those guys such an excellent bunch?
Yeah, we were able to retain a majority of the guys that were a part of Coach Brown and even Coach Reynolds' staff going back 10, 12 years ago. And, Coach Hester has a stalwart here and been here forever, and is going to continue to coach our linebackers, along with Coach Howard, who I brought with me from Bishop Kenny. Coach Hall, we just added as a defensive coordinator, who came over from Middleburg High School, but he's got head coaching experience. Coach Rollerson is a Rolla son, who's similar to my name, but
yes,
no
sir.
Relation, is a D-line coach for us that is going to take care of that position, and he's coached for many, many years. So we've got a nice variety on that side of the ball of guys that have a lot of experience. Offensively, Coach Lawback is our offensive coordinator. He's been here at Fletcher for a while. He'll also coach the offensive line. And then we've added Coach Mike Rich at wide receivers, Coach R.J. Archer at quarterbacks, and then Coach Ashmore's coming back to coach the running backs again. He's got an easy job. We all know that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, turn around and hand it to Miles and Jabari. But they've been great, man. And as I said at the beginning of this, they have made this first week really special because it's been organized, the coaches are dialed in, they know what we're doing, and that's been fantastic. So I'm blessed to have the kind of staff that I have here.
Yes, sir. Coach, you got the job, you got your staff together, then the COVID pandemic threw the world for a loop. Can you just talk about that and how it affected your program spring-wise as well as recruiting? Coach, how did that affect your program?
Yeah, very strange, and I think every coach is kind of looking back and going, man, it's hard to believe that we lost all of these days in the weight room. We lost a bunch of days pre-spring practice where you get out on the field, you start working on some of your concepts, and then you lost 20 days of spring practice. And for being a new coach and a new staff, that's huge. I mean, we were wanting to kind of put our imprint on the program. And once you kind of get past the shock of it, you realize that everybody's in the same boat, and now you got to deal with the hand that's been dealt you. So I think once we figured out, okay, we will get back to football at a certain point, let's utilize what we have at our disposal until then. So we've had a bunch of Zoom meetings, and we've done things as a staff and with our players as much as we possibly could remotely, so that when they're out here, it's not an entirely foreign concept to them when we start talking about plays and football. But it was different. And the recruiting, it affects guys that are in that the borderline between a 1A or an FCS player, those guys that coaches can come lay eyes on. It impacts those guys, but we tell them, look, the one thing that this virus did for head coaches and guys that deal with recruiting is it gave us a chance to really get film out to every coach we needed to get it out to. Because you're sitting there some days and you're going, okay, what can I do today to help our guys get recruited? And that's one of the things that has happened is I and our coaching staff, we've been able to get a bunch of film out to individual position coaches that ordinarily we might not have been able to. So it's affected recruiting. Probably more so on the part of the colleges, because they've just not been able to come look at our guys in person. But hopefully they'll be able to come down a little bit in the fall and see them, and that'll all take care of itself as the season goes on.
Yes, sir. Coach, we know what you're teaching them on the field, but real quick, can you just talk about what you're teaching them off the field?
Yeah, we don't have a ton of rules here. I think you probably heard me say it at the end. Our one golden rule, so to speak, is be in the right place at the right time with the right people, with doing the right thing with the right people. And, we harp on them all the time about you're not representing just you. When you make a poor decision, it is not just you, it's your mama and your daddy, it's your teachers, it's your administration, it's this whole community, and it reflects on our program. And we don't expect them to be perfect, and we tell them that every day, but we do expect them to be held to a standard that is higher than somebody who's not a part of this program, and that is to conduct yourself with dignity and respect and treat women the right way and be where you should when you're supposed to be there. So all of that concept, man, as you know, it takes time to continue to do that, and you just keep pounding it to them every day you see them, and we've got good kids. As I said, the attitude, the effort has been fantastic, and just being on time, something as simple as that. They've all been here on time. We haven't had any guys straggling in late, and that's usually a pretty good indicator that your team is dialed in, at least in mid-June.
Yes, sir, Coach. To the class of 2024 that may be coming in to Fletcher or any school here in the county or in the 904 area that may be finding it hard to get acclimated to the new system, new rules, the new normal, do you got any words of encouragement for them, Coach?
Just be patient. I was telling our group as we left today, you know, nobody knows what the next phase is going to be and when it's going to be. I know that we're supposed to start it next week, but until we hear something, we're out here on the field, you know, every day for an hour. So just be patient. The 2024s that are coming in from the middle schools, just understand that this is a different time we're in right now. And as information comes to us, we'll get that to them. But there's plenty of stuff you can be doing at home and making sure that you're exercising and working out and running and doing all those things you need to do. So when you are able to show up, you're ready to go.
Yes, sir. Coach, two more questions before we get out of here. Academically, y'all one of the leading teams in the county. Can you just talk about that and how proud of you is? Are you guys to step up to the academic challenge?
Yeah, complete reflection of our faculty here at Fletcher. It is fantastic. And as being a first-year teacher in the building, I saw that for myself last year, how involved our teachers are in the lives of our kids. And when a kid is struggling and he needs help, it's not just sink or swim. It's, I'm going to put you in the deep end of the pool, but I'm going to help you wade until you can swim on your own. And that is a tribute to our principal, Dean Ledford, and our vice principals here, and that trickles down to our faculty, who have all done a great job at making sure that academics is a big deal here. We're an A-rated school, and like I said, I just cannot say enough good things about the involvement of our faculty in the lives of our student athletes.
Yes, sir, Coach. Lastly, but certainly not least, we all know what's going on in the world today. Did you get a chance to talk to your kids about what's going on in the world, Coach?
Yeah, I did, and I had individual conversations with what I would have deemed our team leaders and about 10 to 12 guys, and I kind of let them vent a little bit and talk about, you know, how the impact of the events that have happened, which is just pure racism in its worst form, has impacted the way that they view the world. And I encouraged them that this is a time for, in our little corner of the world here in Jacksonville Beach, for us to try to change some things. And it starts with just the way that we treat each other and the way that we try to engage with one another. And it shouldn't matter if you're black, white, or whatever it is. Just the ability to engage and to make people more comfortable and to be able to express yourself without getting angry, without feeling like your opinion is not worthy of being heard. And so what I'm planning on doing is getting, when we can get together as a big group, to have a larger discussion where we're face to face and we're all talking about these things and getting a little bit more of it out in the open with the entire team. But to answer your question, yes, I did. I talked about 10 to 12 of our key junior and senior leaders and had really good conversations with all of them.
Hey, Coach, thanks for talking with me. Good luck to y'all future here at Fletcher.
Hey, thanks, Phil. We appreciate what you guys do.
Appreciate you, Coach.
Yeah, man.
Yes, sir.